John Dalton was the first scientist to give the structure of an atom. According to him, an atom is a solid hard sphere. It is electrically neutral, that is, it has no charge on it. So this was the structure proposed by John Dalton. It is a solid hard sphere. Some years later, a scientist named William Crookes performed an experiment using this apparatus. This is known as a cathode ray tube. He connected this end to a negative terminal of the battery and this end to the positive terminal. So this was the negative terminal and this was the positive terminal. He then switched on the battery. He observed that a beam passed from the negative terminal to the positive terminal. William Crookes called this ray passing from the negative terminal to the positive terminal as cathode rays. In physics, we have studied that unlike charges attract and like charges repel. So if this beam moved from the negative terminal to the positive terminal, so that is, it is attracted towards the positive terminal, so this should be negatively charged. A scientist named J.J. Thomson wanted to verify that this cathode ray consists of negatively charged particles. He repeated the experiment. And then he bought a negatively charged rod near the beam. So see, as he brings the rod near the beam, it gets deflected. It moves away from the negatively charged rod. So he repeated this. So again, in physics you have studied that like charges repel, unlike charges attract. When J.J. Thomson bought the negatively charged rod near the beam, it was deflected. It moved away from the rod. That means like charges repel. So the cathode ray consisted of negatively charged particles. So from this experiment, Thomson was able to conclude that the cathode rays consist of negatively charged particles, which are now called electrons. These negatively charged particles, that is electrons, are an important part of all atoms. And different experiments were performed which showed that the electrons have both definite mass and definite electric charge. So the cathode rays were discovered by, was it Goldstein, Rutherford, William Crookes or J.J. Thomson? So William Crookes had discovered the cathode rays by connecting the ends to the negative and the positive terminal. The cathode ray connected to the negative and the positive terminal. He had discovered the cathode rays. And later on, J.J. Thomson had proven that the cathode rays consist of electrons. But initially, the cathode rays were discovered by William Crookes. Some years later, a scientist named Goldstein, he performed the same experiment. He observed that when the cathode rays move from the negative to the positive terminal, at the same time, a beam moves from the positive towards the negative terminal. So a beam also moves from the positive to the negative terminal. He called this beam as anode rays. So in physics, you know that unlike charges attract. So if a beam moves towards the negative terminal, that means it should be positively charged. So from this experiment, it was concluded that anode rays, that is the rays moving from the positive towards the negative terminal, they consist of positively charged particles, which are now called protons. These positively charged particles or protons are an important part of all atoms. And different experiments were performed which showed that these protons have definite mass and definite electric charge. So let's revise. So if this is the negative terminal, that is the positive terminal. So the beam which moves from the negative towards the positive terminal is known as cathode rays. Since it is attracted towards the positive terminal, so the particles, electrons, they are negatively charged. And the beam which moves from the positive terminal towards the negative terminal, it's known as anode rays. It consists of protons. Since it moves towards the negative terminal, that means these protons are positively charged.